Hi students, this is Tara Ravishankar, Assistant Professor in Department of Media Studies, Christnagar College, Trivandrum. Welcome to our film class. Today we are going to discuss on Mrinal Sen, one of the greatest directors in Indian cinema, who changed the language of cinema or the history of cinema. Mrinal Sen is a master heretic of Indian cinema, very vibrant, talkative, and the uncertain odyssey that he began with the maiden feature film The Dawn, Raat Bhur in 1956. The year after Satyajit Ray, Pather Panjali, The Song of the Road, the masterpiece won the prestigious Best Human Document Award from the Cannes Film Festival. Unlike Ray's film, Mrinal Sen's maiden film proved a ban for him and the film was total disaster. Mrinal Sen says, "My first film is a nightmare. Even I don't like to remember that once I made such a film with a big star cast. My efforts proved abortive and I don't lament it now." His last film, Amar Bhuvan, This My World, was adjudged the best film at Cairo International Film Festival in 2002, and then he was bestowed with the Dada Saheb Phalke Award, the highest honor of Indian cinema, by the President of India. The films that brought glory and high honor to Mrinal Sen is the formative years are Neel Akashir Niche, Under the Blue Sky, Baishi Shravan, The Wedding Day, The Representative or Pratiniti, The Representative, Punashcha, Over Again, Akash Kusum, Up in the Cloud. Each of his films is distinctively different from the other and stands out as a luminous revelation. It may be mentioned it as a kind of realism as understood by him and marks each of his films with a rubric. To him, realism is a means to provoke his spectators to react. It is difficult to tell you in brief what I mean by realism. This is the words of Mrinal Sen. In other words, he repeats, you cannot project a slice of reality physically on screen. What you do by the lensing of a particular object, by the tonal and the linear composition that you create, is that you give a very impressionistic impression of the reality. That is what I also try to do. The physical reality is controlled by me, by my own mental makeup. I want to invest the physical reality with my sensibility by non-contemporary sensibility, reality with a comment. These are the words of Mrinal Sen. The peak period of Mrinal Sen as a radical filmmaker saw fruition in the 60s and 70s. Bhuvan Shom, 1969 movie, produced by the Film Finance Corporation with a shoestring budget of ₹1.5 lakh, is considered as a trendsetter. Again, I repeat the name, Bhuvan Shom, 1969. It is still being treated as the forerunner of Indian New Wave, paving the way for Sara Akash, Gham Hawa, Uski Roti, Duvida, Maya Darpan and Ankur. Then, we know that so many filmmakers followed him, like Basu Chatterjee, M.S. Satyu, Mani Kaul, Kumar Sahani, Shyam Benegal. This period is still remembered as the golden beginning of a new Indian cinema. Says Mrinal Sen, "Those who know me, as you have come to know me from a very close quarter, must admit that I like to show my anger when I find injustice, exploitation, legalized and humiliation. To be angry is my birthright, and I must use it when required. Anger is a purifying agent. By showing anger, you show your protest with urgency against a corrupt system, institution, etc. You need to be angry to challenge all kind of offenses. These are the words of great director Mrinal Sen. According to Mrinal Sen, the portrayal of reality as if is a different thing. The face of Mrinal Sen cinema can be divided into two parts. One is the agit prop kind and the other is humanistic one. The later films are more of a soul-searching kind where he is trying to find out the enemy within. Obviously, the films like Interview 1970, Calcutta 71 1972, Patartik, it is made in 1973, Chorus 1974, Mrigaya, The Royal Hunt, made in Hindi in 1976, belong to agitprop kind in essence and have made with political undertones. The other phase includes films like Mathira Manisha, Two Brothers, made in Oriya in 1966, Oka Oiri Katha, The Outsiders, made in Telugu in 1977, Parashuram, The Man with an Axe, 1978, Ek Din Pradidin, and Quiet Rules the Day, 1979. So, Chalachitra, another film, 1981. Then, Kandhar in 1983, and Janus in 1986. Ek Din Achanak, Suddenly One Day, 1989, made in Hindi. Maha Prithibhi, The World Without, The World Within, 1991. Antari, 1995, etc. A product of IPTA movement, Mrinal Sen never did hide his ideology, motivation in his film. He is known as the rebel filmmaker of Indian cinema to his contemporaries like Anderson, Tony Richardson, Jean-Luc Godard, or Sembene, or Senegal, or such filmmakers of that time, or Fellini. Anyway, in of his statement, Mrinal Sen asserts, defining his films thus, the film does provoke. There was a time when I called myself an agent, and it is not necessary for my audience to agree with me. My business is to provoke them. My business is to disturb the spectator, says Mrinal Sen. I made a film like Patartik 1973, the third of a trilogy on Calcutta, while I was very critical of the moment, Naxalist movement by the Marxist-Leninist, and I made sure that I didn't indulge in slandering them. The lines between self-criticism and slander can be a very thin one. And I was fully aware of that when I made this film. It may be mentioned many of the Marxist-Leninist activists in Bengal did not like the film at all. They hated it. Yet some of them have found it to have substance, politically speaking. For me, he says, that is a good enough, for the film can provoke a discussion of a political nature. He still believes, whether you like his film or not, whether you accept his point of view or not, is another matter. But the very fact he suggests that his film act somewhat of an agent to provoke a dialogue on political issues, that is where he feels he clicks. Even after 53 years or 60 years of film making, Mrinal Sen has not very much changed, and yet again, he admits, he has changed to keep pace with times. On his films, he made a question, and the answer is up to the audience. I also give answers or some suggestions for some answer. My films contain questions to the audience. What I have been going for some time now is to keep an open ending. I don't want to rush to conclusions because I find life to a large extent inconclusive. All that we can do is to analyze the situation so that the audience start asking questions till they find an answer. He says, I am like the city of Calcutta, vibrant, full of vitality. I still continue to serve my own time, do a kind of introspection, self-searching, self-criticism to be more exact, pulling myself by the hair as Peter Way said, and making myself stand before the mirror. I identify with the class from which I come, that is the class of the underprivileged. But there again, I confront a crisis. I am not the same today that I was in the beginning. So I have to have a fight within myself, a kind of duality exists in me. He continues, well, I go my own for the simple reason that when I start a film, I don't really know myself what I am going to do. And I feel like going on location while shooting. You know, I am not a Kurosawa. I am not a Satyajit Ray. I am not Godard, who believe in drawing sketches and bringing on papers for the simple reason that they can't do that. I can't even draw a single line. My films are kind of theaters. In the idea leading to image of cinema, Mrinalsen has a different take. He says, well, I always feel that I have to start with an idea, with a concept. It is indeed the concept that comes to him, not a visual, not as image. According to him, an image or a sound can rise to concept within one. But it is the concept that you start with. The concept is said to be the takeoff point, he emphasizes. From there you keep on going. You think of the images, you think of the sound, you think of the music, and then you think of the tools that are employed in the making of the cinema. Besides, Mrinalsen is the view that audience should take part of the creativity of cinema. It was the point of view of Mrinalsen that the audience should be a part of filmmaking. The director making film, he says, should keep in mind that he has to give some clues to the spectator to help him relate the situation to his own experience. So the audience are expected to relate the situation to their own experience. According to him, that is how the theater, he becomes a creative agent. It is understood that if a condition like that can be created, there is possible only when we make that kind of and always or also we find that a kind of spectator, when a communion can be established between the creator and the spectator, then something else come up. Although his life, Mrinalsen seems rocked by poverty, social exploitation, obsession, or like traumas of marginalized people, he concerns are manifested intensively in his films like Bai Shri Shravan, Calcutta 71, Akalar Sandhyani, which largely deals with feminine poverty and imposed outside. These films, he adds, are close to the heart, and that is why he can say, I am 20, for 1000 years I remain 20. For 1000 years I walk through death, and 1000 years I breathe despair. For 1000 years I see history of unending poverty, history of poverty, of the exploited, of the oppressed and the wronged. When asked about his films, he replied, I'm thinking of a story that grows out of my own experience and filmmaking since I started making film in the 50s. Poverty, famine, social exploitation, identifying inner enemy resistance and the eternal struggle against the political system, making the country from poor to poorer. It is a sort of autobiographical film through exactly notes again. I want to make a film now living the past and interviewing the present, showing how we stand today, perhaps more degraded, more wrong. So that's about Manarsan, and about him, we could say he is born on May 14, 1923 in Bangladesh. After finishing his high school there, he left to Calcutta and then studies physics. During his student days, he involved with the cultural wing of the Communist Party. So you could see the shadows of communism in his films. And he never became a member of the party, but still has communism in his mind. He is interested in cinema, started again like a film of aesthetics. However, his interest remained mostly intellectual, and he was forced to take up a job of medical representative, which took him away from Calcutta. Then it did not last for long, and he came back to the city and eventually took a job of an audio technician in Calcutta Film Studio, which was the beginning of his film career. Mrinalsen made his first feature film in 1953, and his next film, Neel Akashir Niche, Under the Blue Sky, earned him local recognition. And Baishi Shravan Wedding Day was the first film give international exposure. And after making five more films, he made a film with a shoestring budget. The government produced it, Bhuvan Show, Mr. Show. His next few films were overly political and earned him the reputation as a Marxist artist. This was also the time of large-scale political unrest throughout the country. And it was evident in Calcutta city also. And this phase was immediately followed by a series of films where he shifted his focus, and instead of looking for enemies outside, he looked for the enemies within his own middle class society. This was arguably his most creative phase and won him a large number of international awards. Mrinalsen never stopped experimenting with his media. You can see at the age of 80, he made his film Amar Bhuban in 2003. During his career, Mrinalsen's film have received awards from almost all major film festivals like Cannes, Berlin, Venice, Moscow, like that. So apart from his film, he also received a number of personal honors like Padma Bhushan. And in 2005, he was awarded Dada Sahib Phalke, the highest honor given to a filmmaker by the government of India. And he was also an honorary member of Indian Parliament from 1998 to 2003. The French government awarded him the Commander de l'Ordre des Arts of Letters, the Commander of the Order of Arts and Letters, the highest honor conferred by the country. In 2001, the Russian government honored him with the Order of Friendship. He has also received a number of honorary doctorate degrees from various universities. Mrinalsen was the president of the International Federation of the Film Societies. He also served as a member of international jury at various film festivals, including Cannes, Venice, Berlin, Moscow, like that. And in 2007, Mrinalsen completed his autobiographical book, Always Being Born. In 2008, Mrinalsen was awarded a Lifetime Achievement Award by Ocean Cine Fans Festival and by the International Film Festival in India. In 2009, the International Film Festival of Kerala awarded their first Lifetime Achievement Award to Mrinalsen. When going through this, you could see some of the books written by Mrinalsen. It's a very probable question in your examination. What are the books written by Mrinalsen? Always Being Born 2004, Mondash 2002, Cinema Adhunika Kata, Bengali book in 1995, Views on Cinema 1977, Charlie Chaplin 1961, Heat 1943, and a few scripts also. He published the scripts of many of his films. You can see the names of the films here. And now about the books on Mrinal Sen. Books on Mrinal Sen includes all these books. It's all about Mrinal Sen. If you want, you can make preference of Mrinal Sen's books. Profiles like five filmmakers from India. Here you could find Mrinal Sen. And then Mrinal Sen, like that, all these books are about him. Kindly go through this. You can refer for more details on Mrinal Sen. Now about the films of Mrinal Sen. There are short feature films, short films, documentaries. These are the movies. Amar Bhuvan 2002-2003 is the last film made by him. And all these are his films. You can see the films here. So all these are the movies done by him. You can see the series of movies. We have already discussed these names. And about the short films. These are the short films made by Mrinal Sen. And you could see the documentaries made by Mrinal Sen. And the show goes on. Indian Chapter, 1996. Life, City Life, Calcutta by L. Dorado. Then Tripura Prasanga, another documentary. All these are documentary, moving perspectives. Then films on Mrinal Sen. This will be useful for you to know about this filmmaker more. So that's all about Mrinal Sen. Hope you got. You could go through some of the personal photographs of Mrinal Sen about his family and all here. Hope you can check this website, mrinalsen.org. Thank you for listening to me. So that is Mrinal Sen, the great filmmaker of India.